In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Salud, my God, my God.
Let us pray. God our Father, you have loved us with a love unequaled since time began. Born of the Virgin Mary, your Son has come to speak that love to us and has sent us his Spirit to spark its flame in us. We acknowledge and proclaim that you are our Father with the help of Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, our Mother and Patroness. Bring us protection from danger and freedom from sin, that we may come to the joy of your peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. I rejoice heartily in the Lord, in my God is the joy of my soul. For he has clothed me with a robe of salvation and wrapped me in a mantle of justice. Like a bridegroom adorned with a diadem, like a bride bedecked with her jewels. As the earth brings forth its plants, and a garden makes its growth spring up, so will the Lord God make justice and praise spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And raises the lowly. He fills the stars. remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our ancestors, for Abraham and his descendants forever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me?" For at that moment, the sound of your greeting reached my ears. The infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what is spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. And Mary said, My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. The Gospel of the Lord.
The Very Reverend Father Austin Cadiz OSB, Abbot of the Abbey of Our Lady of Montserrat, Very Reverend Father Tarcisio, Abbot Emeritus of the same Abbey, Brother Priests and Monks, Devotees of Our Lady of Montserrat, Brothers and Sisters in Christ. We thank the Lord for gathering us together this Sunday morning to celebrate the Eucharist on the Solemnity of Our Lady of Montserrat. I thank Father Abbot and the monastery community for inviting me to preside at this Mass. This is my first time to visit the Abbey. But I already met some of you during the Vespers with the religious men and women last June 26 at the Manila Cathedral. Thank you for leading the chants that evening. With the celebration of this Mass, we also bring to a close the year-long celebration of the 125th anniversary of the Benedictine presence in the Philippines. In the name of the whole Archdiocese of Manila, I express my profound gratitude to you for your presence in our local church. Your ora et labora are gifts that enrich the Church in Manila. My dear friends, this year's celebration of the Solemnity of Our Lady of Montserrat falls within our celebration of the fifth centenary of the arrival of Christianity in the Philippines. This year, we are invited to be thankful for the gift of Christian faith that we have received. We are also called to share the gift with others. We should not just be recipients of the gift. Our gratitude is best expressed when we share the gift. Hence, the theme of this Jubilee year is Gifted to Give, inspired by the words of Jesus, what you received as a gift, give as a gift. It is in this context that I wish to reflect with you the readings proclaimed to us today. In the Gospel, Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, greeted Mary, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." Until now, that is how we greet Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Until now, we call Mary, Blessed Virgin Mary. Mary is blessed. This is also another way of saying that Mary is gifted by God. And the gift that God gave to Mary is not a thing, not riches, not power, not titles, and not positions of authority. God's gift to Mary is the greatest gift that God could ever give, His only begotten Son, Jesus. Saint Paul, in our second reading today, says, "When the fullness of time had come, God sent His Son, born of a woman, and that woman, the mother of the Son of God, is Mary." Mary is blessed. Mary is gifted with Jesus. My dear friends, especially the monks of this abbey, our Blessed Mother invites us today to recognize our own blessedness. Like Mary, we are all blessed because we have all received gifts from God. In a particular way, I invite you to be thankful for the blessings you, the Benedictines in the Philippines, received. The vocation to contemplative life is itself a precious gift from God. Your being a part of this community is a gift. Your daily response to the call to prayer and work and to fidelity to the rule of Saint Benedict is a gift. The talents and capabilities that each of you possess and that you generously share to the community and to the church are gifts. And I hope that in your community, you consider each other not as problems or burdens, but you look at each other, each member of this abbey, as a gift from God to be valued, cared for, and treasured. Your presence in the Philippines is a gift. For the past 125 years, your order has produced great Filipino Benedictines who have contributed significantly to the church and to society. Your educational institutions produce men and women equipped with knowledge and skills and formed according to the Catholic and Benedictine values. These are gifts we are thanking God for. But after acknowledging the gifts, we are called to share them. That is probably why Mary, after assenting to God's invitation to be the mother of God, went in haste to Elizabeth. She wanted to share the good news. She wanted to share the blessing. Here Mary became a missionary. She brings to Elizabeth and to the baby in Elizabeth's womb the Word made flesh in her own body. Dear brothers, you have undoubtedly been gifted with so much. How do you share them? Especially as we all face these challenging and unprecedented times, to what is God calling you now? Where is God calling you? In what areas of the life of the church and of the society are you called to use your gifts? As we continue to discern the signs of the times, how could you, the Filipino Benedictines of today, and the life that you live, remain relevant? In answer to answer these questions, you need to engage in constant discernment and acquire an attitude of openness to God's call. For this, we come to Our Lady of Montserrat. We ask her intercession, and we entrust to her maternal love, each one of you, and the order of Saint Benedict in the Philippines, so that you may always recognize your gifts, cultivate them, share them, and make them bear much fruit, that in all things God may be glorified. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On the solemnity of Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, let us pray to God for our needs, so that like Mary, we may respond generously to God's invitation to love. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the word of God, which Mary treasured in her heart, may continue to be the source of nourishment in the lives of the Holy Father, the bishops, the clergy, and all who exercise authority in the church. Let us pray to the Lord. that the civil leaders and public servants may work for an equitable distribution of goods, render honest administration, and promote human dignity to all. Let us pray to the Lord. That the Benedictine monks, especially from the Our Lady of Montserrat in Spain, in Manila, and Transfiguration in Malaybalay, may always give witness to the Word of God on their daily lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick in mind and body, especially those afflicted with COVID-19 virus, may find healing and consolation under the mantle of Our Lady of Montserrat. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone before us, especially Father Lesmes Lopez of the Order of Saint Benedict, our departed monks, relatives, friends, and benefactors, may bask into eternal joy with the Father's embrace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community, and for the people entrusted to our care and our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, as we place everything into your hands, may we be assured of your loving care and mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sing, Glory,
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. God our Father, we set before you bread and wine, signs of our fellowship and mutual love. Through the prayers of Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, our Mother and Patroness, may the meaning of our offerings be realized in our lives, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Father Lesmes Lopez of the Order of Saint Benedict. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with our Holy Father, Saint Benedict, Saint Bede, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Thank you.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation and of faith, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that we who devoutly honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, may be worthy to share with her in the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Please be seated.
Peace in Christ Jesus. In behalf of the monastic community, I would like to thank our beloved Cardinal, His Eminence, Jose Cardinal Advincula, for celebrating with us this solemn occasion of the Solemnity of Our Lady of Montserrat. As we thank and pray to the Lord for our 125th year in the Philippines, maraming salamat po, Your Eminence. On the occasion of the 500 years of Christianity and the 125th year of Benedictine presence in our country, we are so blessed and privileged to have you with us, Your Eminence. We are grateful for your encouraging words and inspiring homily, reminding all of us the gifts of the Spirit and the sacred responsibility to share the gift of our charism in the service of the Church in our country. Your Eminence, please continue praying for us and rest assured of our continued prayers for you as you shepherd us and guide us to a deeper relationship with the Lord and one another. Muli po, maraming salamat po, Your Eminence. And I would like also to thank our priests concelebrating at this Holy Mass, especially Father Nico de Liera, Father Prex Fajardo, Father Jack Rada, our Master of Ceremonies, our Abbey guests, and to all of you who are joining us and praying with us through live streaming. We thank our communities in San Beda, Alabang, and San Beda University, Manila, and Rizal, our Bedan family, our alumni, our Benedictine Oblates, and Our Lady of Montserrat devotees, families, and friends. We thank our brothers and sisters in the consecrated life also joining us in this Holy Eucharist. Special thanks to our brother monks in Malaybalay of the Abbey of Transfiguration, our daughter house led by Abbot Eduardo Africa, and the monks of Our Lady of Montserrat, Spain, led by Abbot Joseph Soler. And to all our Benedictine sisters and brothers who are praying with us and celebrating with us today, maraming salamat po. The liturgy is the center of our lives, and so I hope to express also our thanks to our choir, our schola, and instrumentalists, our musicians. Thank you for accompanying us and leading us in singing our praises and thanksgiving to God. On this same day, September 12, 1895, 12 Benedictine monks from the Abbey of Our Lady of Montserrat in Spain, led by Right Reverend Jose Diaz, Abbot of Montserrat, arrived in the Philippines. And right here with us in this Abbey Church is the original image of Our Lady of Montserrat that accompanied the 12 Benedictine monks. For the past 125 years, our Mother Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, never failed to intercede for us and plead for us through her Son, Jesus. In these difficult and trying times of our history, I find consolation in my Lectio Divina in the words of St. Paul, his letter to the Romans, that says, "Who can separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword. Yes, the love of Christ on the cross will lead us through our uncertainties to a deeper experience of the radiant light of the resurrection. Our Mother Mary, who stood at the foot of the cross and accompanies her Son Jesus in doing the will of the Father, will accompany us all, will accompany us all the more in carrying our own crosses. Our Lord's sacrifice on the cross, our Eucharistic celebration here at this altar, continues to assure us that no one can separate us from the love of Christ. Just as our Mother Mary, Our Lady of Montserrat, accompanied the monks in the tumultuous seas on their way to the Philippines and in the history of our monastic community, our Mother will continue to accompany us and intercede for us amidst the stormy seas towards the eternal heights. Just as our Mother Mary, who listened with the ear of her heart the intimate voices of our God, and just as she persevered and stood at the foot of the cross for you and all of us, we have a reason to rejoice amidst this pandemic, and we continue to be grateful to the Lord and to our Mother Mary, who never fails to be with us. And we hope for a deeper faith as we face the future full of trust in His providential care and love. With Mary, our Mother, may our souls continue to magnify His name and glorify Him all the days of our life. Again, thank you and a blessed solemnity to everyone. May God bless us all. Your Eminence, in behalf of the monastic community, please accept this token of gratitude, our humble gift. Accept our humble gift, the image of Our Lady of Montserrat and the icon of Christ, the teacher. Maraming salamat po.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow for the blessing.
May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in His great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with His blessing.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen.
And may you who have devoutly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
God.